In July 2015, actress Paz de la Huerta, known for her roles in movies like Enter the Void and shows like Boardwalk Empire, filed a $55 million lawsuit against Lionsgate Entertainment. The lawsuit claims that while starring in one of their movies, she was hit by a stunt ambulance and suffered an injury that she was not properly compensated for. The suit also said that because of decisions in post-production that made her performance seem worse than it was, the movie ruined her career. The movie in question? Nurse 3D. Nurse 3D is a slasher movie about a sexy nurse who seduces and kills unfaithful married men, and who becomes deliriously obsessed with one of the new nurses at her hospital. The entire movie is a confusing, hilarious mess. The combination of the campy slasher and erotic thriller genres is handled clumsily, and the script reads like an extended opening for a porno movie, with the dialogue being just as hilarious.
As I watch Danny's little round ass, the same one that I'd eaten the night before.
This is the kind of so bad it's good entertainment that the internet loves to obsess over and rag on. Even before the movie was made, the internet was trashing it. Any news article surrounding developments around the movie received comments like, "This sounds like the kind of project that executives lose their jobs over." And their criticism wasn't unjustified. After being completed, the movie sat on a shelf for 2 years before Lionsgate finally released it theatrically and on VOD the same day. At the time, this was the only movie to be released this way, but it was not a move made out of confidence. The movie made a terrible $5,000 domestically, and only $80,000 worldwide. Even accounting for home video sales, the movie's profits don't even begin to cover the expenses of its $10 million budget. Nurse 3D was a flop from the start, and Lionsgate knew it, so they wanted to sweep this movie under the rug as fast as possible by dumping it on VOD, dooming its already poor box office performance. It's clear that Nurse 3D was supposed to be a campy spoof of erotic thrillers and trashy slashers, but it's seldom funny on purpose. The jokes in the script often fall flat, especially when half of them are just doctors sexually harassing and assaulting nurses.
"You'll fit in perfectly. Keep it up."
On top of feeling worthy of a porno, these jokes are even less funny when you remember that Paz de la Huerta was one of the many rape victims of Harvey Weinstein. Meanwhile, there are countless scenes of drama that come off as completely hilarious because of a combination of terrible performances and awful dialogue. There are scenes where you can tell they were going for a campy tone, and they completely nail it.
"Haven't seen you around much.
My schedule's been murder."
But those scenes are few and far between. Then there are scenes like this which just confuse me as to whether it was supposed to be taken seriously or not.
"Are you a little girl?"
"Behind you! No, no! Behind you! Look! Look! No, 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 no! Look! Look behind you! Look behind you!
Despite trying to be a horror movie, it's never really scary, and often its attempts at jump scares are actually unintentionally funny.
"Nobody will ever understand you like I do."
There's also the 3D element of the movie, and while I wasn't able to watch it in 3D, I'm confident it would not have improved the experience, because many of the 3D elements were added in post with CGI. This results in CGI impalement, shower heads, and slit throats, none of which look good in 2D, and all of which, I'm sure, would look even worse in 3D. Yes, this movie was a complete train wreck from the moment it was conceived. While the official story is that the movie was inspired by photographs of nurses taken by Tim Palin, other sources indicate that the idea for the movie came after the marketing campaign for Saw 3D. During the campaign, they sent out women dressed as nurses for a blood drive, and basically, a few producers thought that the idea of a killer nurse was sexy and decided to hire a screenwriter to make a movie about it. In early stages of the production, it seems no one involved in the project had enough confidence in it to put their best foot forward. To direct, the studio hired Douglas Arnie Okoski, who was really only known for being the second unit director for movies like Resident Evil, and up until that point had only directed indie movies that had mixed reception. This, mixed with the cast of non-A-listers, was obviously a decision to help keep the budget low so the studio didn't suffer a massive loss. However, there was one person in the midst of this production who was trying to do something good, and that was the cinematographer, Boris Mosovsky. According to interviews with him and the interviews and director's commentary on the Blu-ray, the movie was supposed to be shot like a colorful neo-noir film. However, in an interview for Deep Fried Movies, the cinematographer said that the studio abandoned his look in post-production, altering the color palette so the movie looked more normal. There's even a flashback sequence in the movie that was shot for black and white with the exception of bright red elements, and the studio altered that too by making it into a scene with desaturated color. Now, I'm not saying that underneath all the studio alterations there's a good version of Nurse 3D, but I am saying that there's probably a version that looks better, and I would definitely be curious to see what that version looks like. The biggest hurdle in this movie's production was, oddly enough, the lead actress, Paz de la Huerta. By all accounts, she seemed difficult to work with. According to the director's commentary, despite having a set hairstyle for the film, she would change her hairstyle every day, and it would always have to be fixed before shooting. One day, she even showed up with a full body tan, despite having filmed every other scene with pale skin. I think this explains why the makeup on her looks horrendous in some scenes. Paz is a very attractive woman, but you wouldn't know it based on the awful makeup she wears in some parts of the movie. If her self-sabotaging behavior wasn't enough, she was also struck by a stunt ambulance which injured her. Lionsgate gave her $73,000 in workers' compensation, and they would later fight over this in court because of her lawsuit. And all of this trouble was to secure a performance that turned out to be laughably terrible.
You're sick, Sarah. Let's get you better. I care about you.
You had your chance to be my friend!
It's the kind of performance so bad, you're unsure if the actress was actually trying. Especially in scenes where she has to show a lot of emotional range, like when she's trying to woo the other nurse, her acting is really amusing.
I know how you feel. I lost my father when I was 8 years old.
I understand you. Nobody understands you like I understand you. Nobody.
The movie also features voiceover narration, which was originally dubbed by Paz herself, but the studio was unsatisfied with it. So without informing Paz, Lionsgate hired another voice actress to redub the voiceover.
My name is Abigail Russell. I look like a slut, but don't be fooled.
When reviews came out slamming Paz's performance, she insisted that what they took issue with was the redubbed voiceover. Obviously, that was not the case. Her performance is genuinely bad, and in the studio's defense, the voice actress that got to redub the voiceover did a decent job. Her performance is honestly better than Paz's, and it actually fits the neo-noir tone they were going for. All of these events eventually culminated in the lawsuit filed by Paz against Lionsgate Entertainment. The lawsuit claimed three things. The first is that she was not paid proper compensation for her onset injury. Second, she claimed that their use of a voice actress to redub the movie was an illegal use of her likeness. And finally, she claimed that studio decisions made in post-production tainted her performance in the movie and ruined her career. The lawsuit felt very arrogant and entitled, especially in the context of Paz's behavior during production. Every claim the lawsuit made was completely baseless. It was such a ridiculous situation that, with all sorts of media outlets covering it, the lawsuit was probably the most exposure Nurse 3D ever got post-release. So it was no surprise when California's Second Appellate District Court struck down the lawsuit. The claim that she wasn't compensated for her injury was struck down because, well, obviously she was. But they also denied her other claims. Lionsgate redubbing the movie was not an illegal use of Paz's likeness. Paz agreed to be in the movie, and it was Lionsgate's movie. If they wanted to completely redub the entire movie with an actress that sounded nothing like her, they were well in their right to do so. The poor critical reception of her performance was not a result of the redubbed voiceover, but a result of Paz's own work in the movie. The court also said that she failed to prove any damages as to how the movie ruined her career. Despite it being a massive failure, Paz has consistently starred in movies since Nurse 3D. Sure, they're not the kind of movies that are going to make her an A-lister, but those were the kind of obscure movies she always played in. And if you read the court's full decision, it reveals even more ridiculous claims that had to be put to rest. For example, in order to get more compensation money, Paz even tried to frame the stunt accident as an intentional homicide. She also claimed damages because she suffered severe emotional distress as a result of watching the movie. The entire lawsuit was a circus performance, and a bizarre conclusion to the story of Nurse 3D's production. If there was one positive to the production of Nurse 3D, it was the involvement of marketing director Tim Palin, whom I previously mentioned as being an inspiration for the movie. Known for making posters for John Wick, Saw, Hunger Games, and many more, he created a set of posters for the movie that look fantastic. They depict an enticing blend of horror imagery and sex appeal that I'm sure the movie was trying to go for. From conception to execution, Nurse 3D was a hilarious mistake. It is a complete dumpster fire that has remained in relative obscurity despite its explosive behind-the-scenes drama. And I think that's a shame because it's one of my favorite bad movies. This is the kind of ridiculous, unintentionally funny movie that deserves the kind of cult following that movies like The Room enjoy. Between its porno-esque script, its terrible performances, and the wild behind-the-scenes story that accompanies it, I'm surprised it doesn't have that kind of following yet. I hope that in time it does get that kind of recognition, because without a doubt, Nurse 3D is a movie too bizarre to be forgotten. I am Randall the Vandal, and thank you for watching.